call it social media shaming parents, now reportedly finding a lot tougher when it comes to disciplining their kids. That's because they think too harsh of a punishment could end up online and result in a backlash. So could the internet be creating a generation of fear in parents? Let's ask our parenting panel that question. Joining us now, Chris Kensler, Fox 411 editor, Siggy Flicker, relationship expert, and mother of seven, Rachel Campos Duffel. Good morning.
Good morning to you.
How are you? So what do you say about that, Siggy?
I say you can't be in fear of raising your kids. I have four children, two stepchildren, two of my own. In my house, they're my rules. And the first thing when anybody gets in trouble in my house is I take away the thing that they love the most, and that is their phone. So they can't videotape me, and if they did, I'd be proud of them videotaping me. I say, if you don't like my rules, collect your change, move out, and get your own place.
Wow. Chris, are these kids really videotaping their parents when they're taking some punishment now?
I've seen a couple of those out there, and if that happened to me, I would probably wear it as a badge of honor. I'd say, please
keep videotaping. Absolutely.
This is the kind of popularity I want with your friends. I'm the mean guy.
Yeah, well, listen, I got my start in television on reality TV on The Real World, so I already have a lot of bad moments in my 20s.
So they can't turn you in for those,
but I was going to say, you know, if you're Latina like I am or Italian and you parent with some yelling, I mean, it can strike the fear of God in some people to see that online and have people comment because the family is a really intimate place.
And not just yelling. I'm Jewish and I'm always yelling. Yeah. But you know what? I happen to think that I don't want my kids growing up with entitlement issues. I want them to know, full hands in and out, pick up the things and put them in the dishwasher.
But if they're posting, this came from a story in the Daily Mail. If they're posting, you've probably already lost control at this point. So this is about taking back control as a parent.
Absolutely. Hey,
Chris, can you get control of these kids by telling them, say, well, you post something on me, I'm going to post something on you.
Yeah.
How about that?
That's one way to do it. Yes. I will say, with our generation we might have more trouble seeing ourselves online than our kids' generation. So I do see how parents could be a little freaked out by that.
Yeah.
But I think you got to get over it because these kids post everything. Their whole lives are online.
I learned a lot. I wasn't really aware of that. Now, the second topic for this morning is, does separating boys and girls help students perform better in school? Now, in the past, we've had girls' schools, boys' schools, different Catholic and other religious schools where they split the sexes. Well, what do you say?
I say it depends on your child. In my home, I have a 12-year-old who's boy crazy and a 15-year-old who's girl crazy, and I think it would help them concentrate more if they went to school. And I mean, my kids are in the front of the class. It's the teacher and then my daughter, Sophie. And she still finds time to turn around to see what Tommy's doing.
Yeah.
So it depends on your child.
And I think you learn in school, you're learning your subjects, but I think the other thing that you're learning is how to be with people
that
and be
correct.
With the opposite sex. I think that's as big a part of school as it is learning your
it is,
reading,
but
writing, and arithmetic.
They're going to meet boys and hang out with boys outside of school. I look at the amount of, I can look at myself. I don't even have to look at my teenage daughter to know how much time I spent getting ready for school. I went to a co-ed Catholic school. I think that time would have been spent thinking about academics and not about the cute boys in class or all the time I spent before school getting ready. And by the way, all the fights we have with our daughters before
Absolutely.
School.
Absolutely, before school, and what they're wearing. So, and by the way, weekends, I know that your schedules
are busy.
Why
does it take girls so long to get ready?
Because
they're doing it for the boys. And also, they have time to mingle and mix. I do agree with you that we need to teach them how to, you know, communicate with the opposite sex. That's what life is about. But their weekends are filled with parties, bat mitzvahs, bar mitzvahs. Their social calendar is very busy.
And they're learning how to interact by watching you and your husband interact as well.
If the school's struggling and they're trying something new and they think that separating the sexes is going to help and they're seeing that it helps, I think that's probably worthwhile.
But the studies are showing that it does help.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, that's pretty good. Siggy, Chris, Rachel, thanks for being part of this panel. That's good. Come back soon.
Thank you so much.
Happy Saturday.